There are a lot of people who think watching violent media, and in particular taking part in violence in computer games, is bad for us, potentially turning us into programmed, emotionless killing machines. Now, I imagine many people watching this, like me, watch violent movies and play violent computer games. So let's have a look at the theoretical basis of these ideas and see if there's actually any evidence backing it up. Psychboost.com, over 170 videos to help you with your qualification, and Patreon supporters can access bonus resources, tutorial videos, and the Discord channel. Media influences on aggression. When we use the word media, it's a pretty broad term. It can include the internet, TV, and computer games. But it also can include old methods of mass communication like the radio, books, newspaper publishing, and even art. The concern about aggression and the media is if seeing depictions of aggression in visual media can lead the viewer to become more aggressive in their day-to-day life. Now, we've already covered social learning theory in this unit, and many of the ideas that we covered there transfer over to the media. There are models, not live but symbolic, on our TV screens, displaying a range of behaviours. Now, we're very likely to identify with these models. The people who make TV shows design characters who are relatable. We're also more attractive than average. We also tend to watch TV shows about people like us, or who we'd like to be. Now, if we're watching, say, a superhero movie, and the attractive lead hero uses aggression to solve their problem, and we see that they're rewarded for that aggressive behaviour, social learning theory suggests an observer is vicariously reinforced, and is likely to imitate that aggressive behaviour. We could also say people's moral decision-making processes can be altered by the constant exposure to media aggression. The hero's actions are often shown to be justified in some way. One example, if you've seen John Wick, he kills like 90 people in that film, often in horrific ways. But some of those people are responsible for killing John Wick's puppy, and others are getting in the way of his revenge, so fair enough. So constant exposure to the idea that extreme violence can be justified is thought to change the way an individual thinks about their own responses when they feel wronged. Media influences and aggression, the effects of computer games. Now, the specification is clear that we should be aware of the possible effects of computer games. Now, all the points I've just made apply to computer games, but there are some features that are unique and might influence aggressive behaviour. Firstly, watching TV and movies is a passive experience, but in the computer game you have agency, you decide what to do. Often this is by controlling an avatar. Many games are set up in a way that aggressive behaviour is actually the only way to play and progress. Not only that, but high scores and access to loot reward more extreme and effective aggressive behaviour. This isn't just vicarious reinforcement, this is direct reinforcement, so operant conditioning. But there is a counter idea about the effects of video games on aggression. Perhaps it reduces real life aggressive behaviour by providing a safe place to release aggressive emotion without anyone getting hurt. That process is a Freudian term called catharsis, the release of an intense emotion leading to a feeling of relaxation. Desensitisation, disinhibition, and cognitive priming. There are also three other processes that we need to be able to understand and explain, and that's how the media could lead to desensitisation, disinhibition, and cognitive priming. Now, to be desensitised is to lose the extreme emotional response we feel when presented with a stimulus. So if we're shown the results of extreme aggression, such as pictures of people killed in warfare, if we're not desensitised, we would feel a sense of disgust and anxiety. So it's suggested we won't be aggressive in order to avoid feeling those unpleasant emotions. But if we are exposed constantly to horrific images, then that sense of disgust reduces. We are desensitised, and theoretically more able to commit violence ourselves. Disinhibition is about socialisation. We're shown from a very young age that our aggressive acts are disapproved of. Usually we're punished in some way whenever we display aggression. Over time, we become inhibited. We understand that aggression is not the way to resolve conflict. But aggression in the media is often shown to be acceptable, and this is thought to counteract feelings of inhibition. And finally, cognitive priming. This is based on the cognitive idea of schemas, mental scripts that are automatic ways to behave in certain situations. For example, in school, maybe you stop talking, check your desk is tidy, and stand up, eyes front, when the head enters the room. The presence of the school head is a cue for a pattern of behaviour. You may not realise you're doing all of that consciously, you're following a mental script that you've picked up, mostly from observation of other people's behaviour. It's also suggested we can learn aggressive scripts from watching movies. Perhaps the hero, when threatened with a knife, fights back in a particular way. Being threatened with a knife then becomes what's known as a priming stimulus. And then perhaps a few months later, the person who watched the movie is mugged in the street by an attacker with a knife. This theory suggests that a similar context triggers the script, and the victim will try to act out the hero's aggressive response. Media influences on aggression. Research evaluation. So this section of aggression is a little complex. We need to know about the media's link to aggression in general, how computer games in particular can influence aggressive behaviour, and the process of desensitisation, disinhibition, and cognitive priming. I'm going to give you a set of research evaluations that you can use a couple of if you're asked an essay question about the media's role in aggression in general. We're going to make sure that you've got something if you're asked to write about just one aspect. So firstly, we discussed Williams' Canadian study in social learning theory, and we can use it again here. Her observation of playground aggression before and after the introduction of television in an isolated town did show a clear increase in both verbal and physical aggression after the introduction of TV. And this is argued to be because children now exposed to a range of aggressive models they had never been before, and they were imitating the aggression they had observed on TV in their playground. A study we can use if you want to talk about computer games and desensitization is by Kanagi and Anderson. In this experimental setup, participants would play either a violent or non-violent computer game for 20 minutes, and then watch a 10-minute video clip of real-world violence like recordings of police shootouts. The researchers found by measuring galvanic skin response and heart rate that people who had played violent computer games had lower readings, indicating a reduction in their stress response. So in other words, they were desensitized to violence. Now, if you want to extend this evaluation, obviously this study only shows a short-term effect. But the biological measurements do give it some credibility, as people can't fake them like they might do with self-report measures. A study that we can use when talking about disinhibition is by Berkowitz and Powers. This study got male participants to watch an aggressive clip from a TV show. They were also given a written summary of the show. The participants whose written summary suggested the violence they had seen was justified were more likely to go on to be aggressive to a confederate in a follow-up task. It suggested that being exposed to justification of aggression led to disinhibition of their own aggressive response. A study by Murray supports cognitive priming. Children were placed in an fMRI machine and shown violent and non-violent videos. Now, a bunch of brain regions activated to both videos, but interestingly, some only activated to the violent videos. As the amygdala activated in response to the violent videos, Murray argued this is evidence of a real emotional response to the violence. And one area of the posterior cingulate is associated with long-term memory storage, with Murray suggesting this is evidence of the observer storing scripts. General evaluations. Okay, let's consider some general evaluations. People have been having concerns ever since computer games came out. In fact, the first example of a moral panic was due to a game called Death Race. In this driving game, you're encouraged to hit pedestrians. The safety officials at the time complained that there's something different about video game violence. The person is no longer a spectator, but an actor in the process of creating violence. And the game is sick, sick, sick. Well, trigger warning. I'm about to show you a clip of me playing this sick, sick, sick game. Okay, let's do this. Yes, got you. Come on, come on, come on. Got you. Kill, 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 kill. Yeah. Hide it. Yeah. Oh, no, I'm stuck. Stuck, stuck. Oh, my God, stuck. Got ya. Can't move. Got ya. Over here. Come out, come out, come out, come out, come out, come out. Run into me. Okay, they get the sky. Yes! I want to kill. Now, I have one main problem with these ideas of video game violence causing real-world aggressive behavior. This is because people have been complaining for years about a potential connection between violent video games and real-world violence. But The reality is, across Western societies, violent crime in the streets, across all measures, have been trending down since around the 80s. This is at the same time as the number of people who play violent video games has exploded massively. This graph shows a peak for aggression in the UK in 1995. This was the year both Mortal Kombat the movie came out, and the game of the year was Mortal Kombat 3. Shocking aggression. These early Mortal Kombat games generated a massive amount of concern and even attempts to get them completely banned, leading to debates about if computer games count as free speech. Now, this is a point where I was going to show you a clip and comment on the fatalities in the new Mortal Kombat 11. But honestly, I think if I did, I would actually disgust some of you. But if you want to see how horrific modern day games can be, with extreme aggression and photorealistic gore, I'll link you to a review of the fatalities by a real ER doctor. So, how come this hasn't led to a total breakdown in society? How is it that violent crime is so low if video game aggression is so dangerous? Well, on the one hand, I do think this gives the theory a real problem of face validity. The real world data just isn't backing up their ideas. But one interesting idea is this. Maybe video games do have a negative effect. But because video games are now so popular, it's led to a massive change in how young males, the ones so likely to commit violence, spend their time. It used to be that young people would spend a lot of time on the streets, with lots of opportunity to meet rival groups and come into conflict. But now, these males are inside playing games, still being aggressive, perhaps more aggressive than ever. But that aggression is limited to virtual environments. But we did suggest that actually computer game aggression is cathartic. And when computer gaming males were actually asked about their gaming, Kestenbaum found that video game users did report they played when they felt wound up, and would feel more relaxed after a gaming session. Supporting the ideas that males can release pent-up aggression in-game, making them less aggressive in real life. There is a lot of research that looks at the viewing habits of young children and then looks to see if that matches the aggression shown by the same children when they're older. And many do show a correlation, but I've not included those studies in this video as I think there's a significant problem with them. It's likely that people who are aggressive will pick out aggressive media to watch and play. But finally, if psychological research does show that there are links between media use and real-world aggression, this can inform policymakers who can decide regulations like age rating certain games and potentially banning certain types of games. Here is a real aggression exam question. Give it a go and see how you do. I want to thank everybody who supported this channel over on Patreon during the creation of the aggression unit. You're helping to make the development of these free ALevel videos possible. And if you're a PsychBoost patron, then you're on level and above, you can access 6 bonus aggression tutorial videos over on psychboost.com. In them, I'll talk you through a model answer for the exam questions, and I'll share some general exam tips based on the exam reports. Senate's patrons and above can access a printable poster, a quiz sheet covering the aggression unit, and an essay table. Neuron can get a set of worksheets and the script to this video. I've designed all of that to work alongside these videos to make a complete set of notes and revision materials. But for everybody else, like and subscribe so you don't miss videos released right up to your exams.